To set up Flutter on a freshly installed Ubuntu 20.04, the first thing you're going to need is Android Studio. And it is actually really easy to install Android Studio on Ubuntu. All you need is just one command. So we're going to go open terminal, and we're going to write sudo apt. No, actually it's going to be snap install Android Studio and then flag classic. And then we enter a password. And this is going to go ahead and download all the necessary files, and it's going to set it up for us. And this is all you need to do to install Android Studio. The next thing is we will have to download the Flutter SDK. To do that, what we will do is we will head over to Google Chrome or whatever browser you use, and then search for Flutter SDK. And the flutter.dev website, this is the one we're looking for. Scroll down a little bit and click on Linux. And then this is the file that we need to download. But before that, there are these shell utilities or dependencies that we need. So make sure you have them. And the way to know whether you have one of these or not is to simply type which and then the name of the program. So which bash, and if it comes up with a response, that means this thing is already installed. So which curl would come up with the response. And if you write something which blah blah blah, you know you don't have it, so it won't return any path. And if this happens for one of these dependencies, what you're going to want to do is you just come on and install it. And it's really really easy to install these. So for example, if you want to install curl, sudo apt install and then the name of the dependency. So curl, for example, curl is already the newest version. And yeah, this is pretty much it. And then you're going to want to download this file here. I already have it in my downloads folder, so we're going to go ahead and create a folder for this. So I usually like to call this SDKs, and now I'll cd into that folder, and now I will just extract it into this folder that I just created. So this command is also listed under the Flutter dev website. So we'll give it a time. And now it's extracted, and this is the directory that we need to add to our path so that we can use Flutter from the CLI here. Okay, so now I'm going to edit the bashrc file. Let me just copy this from here because I'm going to need it later on. So Control plus L to clear the screen. And let's edit. I use Vim, but you can use whichever editor you want. Control plus end to go to the end of the file, I to insert, and shift plus insert to paste it. And then I will just write a path to this directory. Okay, I don't know if I can use this. Let me just write it. And we can just copy the path from here, so I can enter the absolute path here. Okay, let's go back, and I'll actually just delete, get rid of this path that we already have, and I'll just paste the one that I copied. So paste it, fix the quotation marks. I'll have to insert, go to the insert mode and remove this useless one, and this is it. Just write quit. Now I saved my changes and exit. Okay, so we have to restart the terminal to see if it has picked up. So there you go, fetch Flutter, just like the other dependencies, shows a path to that. And if you press Flutter version, you will see it will go ahead and fetch all the versions that are available. So if you want to see the in currently installed version, you're going to have to specify version as a flag. So flutter-version is going to give you this. Okay, so moving forward, Flutter precache. We just write this to load all the dependencies. Oops. Okay. Failed to download the Android dependencies. Let's try Flutter Doctor to see what's wrong. Oh, unable to locate Android SDK. Okay, so I think I know what the problem is. What we need to do is, I think we need to open Android Studio at least once, because we just installed it. So when you launch Android Studio for the first time, it goes ahead and sets up the SDK and everything in a small wizard. So let's go ahead and actually I'll just add this to my dash so that I can later on access it easily. And let me just move it up a little bit. And it's opening. No, do not import settings because it's a brand new installation. Don't send. And then next. Standard. I like dark themes, so I'll go with the dark one. Next. And since Linux supports faster Android emulator, which is great, so click finish. Now this will go ahead and download all the required files. This could take some time, so I'm skipping to the end. So we click finish. And the next thing is to install the dependencies again. So let's do precache, and there we go. Now it's downloading the Maven dependencies. So I guess this is what was wrong. So this could take some time. We'll let it finish. And then we go back to Android Studio. And here we have to install a few plugins. And to do that, we hold Control Shift and A and then type settings. Control Shift A and type settings. This is going to open the settings screen. Then head over to plugins. And in the marketplace, you're going to want to search for Flutter. So you just type Flutter here and click install, accept, and this is going to want to install Dart on its own, so we click yes, and boom, it's installed. And on a fresh Android Studio install, I always install this material theme. I really like this theme, so it's completely optional if you want to install it or not. But I usually do it, so we download the theme and also material icons. Atom material icons is a nice theme for icons. Okay, now we're gonna restart the IDE. And it's restarting. And there is this small wizard for the material theme. Whenever you install it, it's gonna ask you all these questions. Keep clicking next, next. Next, start using Android Studio. And it has opened behind the terminal. Okay, we're looking good. Let's start a new Flutter project. We click Flutter application. Click next. And here we're going to have to give the path to the place where we installed the Flutter SDK. So in my case, home directory, SDKs, and Flutter. Okay, looks good. And next, and then we click finish. And this is going to go ahead and create the Flutter project. And this could take a little while also. Let me just maximize the screen. and okay, so this looks good. Okay, there's an update for the Firebase plugin. Let me just do it really quick, and I think it's okay to restart the IDE. Okay, now we want to install an Android emulator, and that's necessary if you want to build apps for Android. So we will select, I typically like Pixel 3 XL because the frame is rather nice, and I would go with Android Q, which is Android 10. That seems to be much more stable at the time of recording this video. Now this is going to go ahead and download all the files that are necessary for running this Android emulator, and of course this could also take some time. You're gonna have to be a little bit patient with this. This is almost done. Unzipping. Okay, finish. And then we are going, since we already have this one, we click next, click finish, and we have it. Now we're gonna click this play button to launch the emulator. We can close that window. And typically I would want my Android emulator to be always on top, so that it doesn't keep going behind it. So the way to do that is Alt plus space, focus on the Android emulator, and then hit Alt and space, and the menu shows up. You'll have to do this two times, one for the emulator and one for the menu on the right side. So now the emulator will stay on the top of this window. Okay, looks like it's ready. Let's see the performance. It's reasonably fine. And okay, so now the boilerplate code that was generated, we're just going to launch this on this emulator. It's going to go ahead and build it, and then once it is done, it's automatically going to launch it on the emulator. While it's doing it, let me just switch the emulator theme to dark, because that's a little bit comfortable to work with, for me at least. So now it's cool. Okay, let's see, it's building it still. Let's wait for it to finish the process. And now it's launching it on the emulator, and there you have it. It is launched, the app is working. You can click the plus icon and it's going to increment the number. So theoretically at this point, your Ubuntu 20.04 is well capable of running Flutter applications. And by the way, this supports a hot reload also. So if you make any change and just save it, you are immediately going to see it in the emulator. So Flutter on Ubuntu 20.04, you can probably see the app bar change. So let's change title, let's change it again, and every time you save the file, it's going to go ahead and apply the changes in the simulator. So there you can see, let's change title, actually modified it. And then to turn off the emulator, just long press the power button and click power off. And that is pretty much it. Now this is all you need to set up your Ubuntu 20.04 installation for building Flutter apps.